And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Judgment Rites Blind. New episode, Museum Piece.
How long until we reach Nova Atar, Ensign?
About 23 hours, Captain.
22 hours, 53 minutes, and 17 seconds, to be precise.
Damn it, Spock.
There's no need to be precise. We're going on shore leave. Rest, relaxation, no calls from Starfleet.
Until...
Captain, we have a message coming in from Admiral Richards at Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
Hello, Jim. I know you're going on shore leave, but...
What is it, Chris?
But...
Since you're going there anyway, and it's only a small favor...
Favor?
I don't want to inconvenience you, but...
Fine, but... you have it. What would you like me to do?
We recently discovered that one of the exhibits in the Smithsonian Annex at Nova Atar is of great historical significance to the Serenzi, an influential family from planet Lockean. The museum is going to have a small ceremony to return the item. The Federation planned to send a representative, but, well, she couldn't make it. Since you'll be in the neighborhood, well, no dress uniforms. All you have to do is smile and shake hands.
Smile, shake hands. It would be my pleasure, Admiral. My chief engineer had already promised to show me around. We'll be there.
Thanks, Jim. I owe you one. Check your data files for details. Oh, one more thing, Jim. Due to the security concerns, you won't be allowed to bring any electronic equipment with you. Richard's out.
Now, I was saying...
Captain, do we really have to stand around and listen to speeches from a bunch of politicians?
It won't be all bad, Scotty. The curator's a major cognac producer, and he asked us to show up early to thank us for our support.
Captain, it'd be rude to keep a man like the curator waiting, what with an important diplomatic function to prepare for.
Oh, brother. Anyway, yeah, just trying to get the new Batman Telltale games working, and... the freaking game won't work, crashes at startup, and, well, so we're gonna play some more Star Trek until they patch the game, hopefully. So...
All sensors are clear, Captain.
Let's look up some of the files. Like the, whoever this guy from Starfleet said we should do. Nova Atar.
Nova Atar. A Federation Atar. System whose third planet, Nova Atar 3, is the home of the Smithsonian Annex for this sector of the galaxy. Nova Atar is renowned for its rich collection of artifacts.
Mm-hmm. Smithsonian Annex.
Smithsonian Annex. Location, Nova Atar. A large museum annex with exhibits ranging from some of the earliest technology in the galaxy to the most recent declassified recoveries of salvaged Klingon wreckage. The museum administration bans equipment from being brought into the museum.
Boo.
A force field also protects the museum from an intruding transporter beam.
Huh. Guess we're taking a shuttle down. Who is this Admiral Richards? Nope. Serenzi.
Serenzi, a large, influential extended family among several controlling Lockean. Cross-reference entry, Lockean.
Okay. Lockean.
Lockean. Governed by large, extended families, the inhabitants of this world escaped a dying planet several generations ago to relocate to Lockean. After a troubled period of re-establishment of their culture and industrial base, the Lockeans recently petitioned for admittance into the Federation.
Okay. So let's save. I don't know what episode we're up to. 25, I think?
Save new game.
Right, Let me just double check. I think that is it right there. So let me just look really quick. Nova Atar is number 16. Which, yeah, appears to be this one. Engage.
We've arrived at Nova Atar, Captain.
Bring us into standard orbit, Mr. Sulu.
Aye, Captain.
I'm wondering if no fight again. Apparently no battle again. I've been really enjoying that. There's only been a couple battles.
We are at Nova Atar.
Should we tell them we're here? We can't beam down, right?
Curator Bresnia bids you to beam down at your pleasure.
That sounded almost sinister. Okay, well, shields are already down. I guess we beam down outside the museum and then walk in, something like that.
Mr. Scott, Mr. Chekhov, come with me. Mr. Spock, you have the car.
Oh, Spock's staying behind. I have Scott and Chekhov.
Captain Kirk, good to meet you. I am Boris Bresnia, curator of the museum. Everyone is buzzing about visitors from the Enterprise. A real feather
visitors.
In my
cap.
The pleasure is ours, sir. This is my chief engineer, Mr. Scott, and Ensign Chekhov, our navigator.
Most pleased to meet you both. Chekhov, a fine name.
Fellow Russian.
I'm certain you will be interested in sampling the Kazakhstani cognac, distilled and blended by my family.
Hey, Scotty wants that.
In fact, I will later show you my most prized possession. A bottle of our finest vintage. Aged
vintage.
40 years from our very first press.
But isn't cognac French?
Originally, Mr. Scott. But before my ancestors came to settle this planet, they went to cognac and purchased cuttings, brought them here, and made enhancements. You could say we reinvented cognac.
Well, you used a V there.
I do not wish to be rude, but you gentlemen are a bit early, and I must see to making certain the cleaning crews are finished working. Please, feel free to look about a bit. I will page you later, and maybe you will join me in a small toast before the ceremonies. Yes.
It would be our pleasure, Curator.
So the guy can't pronounce V's. He's using W's, but then using V's in place of other letters.
I told you we invented it. Maybe we were a little hard on you, laddie.
Never doubted you for a second, Mr. Chekhov. Now let's take advantage of this time and look around.
Indeed. First we'll look at ourselves.
Chekhov is pleased to finally be with someone from his ancestral culture. Kirk seems to be enjoying the leisurely stroll around the museum. Scotty thinks this is the best shore leave he's ever had.
Yeah. Well, we just got here, so don't get too excited.
Lights cascade continually above the surface of this device. Plaques on each side read, "The Vandecourt Aurora Generator was donated to this museum by Sir William Loudon." Originally, a university experiment designed to test broadcast power as both a containment system and photostimulation for possible use in a propulsion system, the unit was presented as a gift to Loudon, who liked the way it looked and had recently donated a significant sum to the university.
Okay.
Lights cascade can... The plaque reads, "The Niven, non-integrated Vulcan electronumerator, was one of the earliest versions of a Vulcan computer. Some of the components were found to only function correctly at high temperatures. Since the focus in those early days was on computational effectiveness and not user-friendliness, the operator could not stand near the Niven during its operation. Input to the machine was cabled in from a separate device, hence, it was a non-integrated computer."
Huh. That's crazy. You can't stand near it, what, because it gets the heat from your body or something?
The plaque reads, "The Niven, non-integrated Vulcan electronumerator."
Oh. It only functions correctly at high temperatures. So why can't you stand near it?
The plaque reads, "The Niven, non-integrated Vulcan electronumerator, was one of the earliest versions of a Vulcan computer. Some of the components..."
Because it wasn't user-friendly. You couldn't stand near it. Well, sparks fly out of the thing, or what?
The plaque reads, "An old ground-based phaser cannon model B-17, the real equalizer, rescued from a Federation scrapyard, probably based on the frontier near Nellipur. This phaser cannon no longer possesses any of its focusing or targeting equipment. The large capacitors in the base allowed a variety of power sources to be used to energize the cannon and gave the real equalizer considerable flexibility in use."
Hmm.
The walls of this hexagonal exhibition room appear quite sturdy. Although some exhibits are old, all are well maintained.
Well, I wasn't trying to look at the wall. I was looking at this thing, which appears to be some sort of map or something.
The walls of this The Klingon console looks operational, but without a ship attached, it's hard to tell. Written on the plaque, this is a control console from a Klingon warbird, the Clarg, which was salvaged from the battle wreckage near Crimmins 8.
Think you could make that work, Mr. Scott?
Of course, Captain. But it's not like I'll ever have to.
Hmm. The Clarg.
A typical computer-controlled door.
What's this thing?
The walls of this
A
heavy set of double doors. When open, good for moving large items through. When closed, good for stopping large items from moving through.
Hmm.
I imagine this is how you decorate your home, Mr. Scott.
Aye, Captain. But as leave all the parts in, most of this has been gutted. You know, this is a fine place, Captain. We'll have to come here for shore leave more often.
Maybe they'll display a piece of the Enterprise here someday, Captain.
Maybe they will, Mr. Chekhov.
They'd better not. Taking a piece out of that grand lady would be like cutting the head from the statue of the Antares Maiden and putting that on display.
Interesting analogy, Mr. Scott. But you have to admit that someday even the Enterprise will be put into dry dock.
He will not.
I think we'll agree with Mr. Scott on this one, don't you think, Mr. Chekhov?
Yes, Captain.
Good answer.
Maybe they'll display a...
Oh, wait.
Maybe they will.
They'd better not.
Interesting and...
He will not.
I think...
Yes, Captain.
I thought that was Scott's dialogue.
I've never seen one of these up close before.
A beauty, isn't it, Captain?
I'll take your word for it, Mr. Scott.
Hmm.
Interesting piece of Klingon machinery. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Why is that not necessary? But you walk over to other things.
Maybe we should install one of these in the Enterprise. What do you think, Mr. Scott?
I think not, Captain.
Just a thought, Mr. Scott.
Gotta walk all the way back.
This looks interesting.
I realize the temptation is there, but I don't think the museum wants you rewiring exhibits, Mr. Scott.
He was just looking.
I don't understand what you want me to do, Captain.
Well, look at this thingy.
I suppose this is interesting, but tampering with equipment will set off alarms. We hardly want trouble on our shore leave. No souvenirs, Mr. Scott.
Wah.
No playing with the exhibits, Mr. Chekhov.
Jeez.
This is a bit beyond me, Captain.
I suppose this is interesting, but tampering with equipment will set off alarms. We hardly want trouble on our shore leave.
He was really strong on arming some wires over there.
I wonder if this old walking computer would be embarrassing to Mr. Spock.
No, laddie. That would not be logical.
Hmm. Alright. Do we have...
Captain Kirk and party, please report to the curator's office, please. Captain Kirk and party, please report to the curator's office.
I'm not done over here.
I hope you enjoyed your tour, gentlemen. Please join me. Would you mind if the first toss with the Kazakhstanian was to the Enterprise?
Curator? Why isn't that Bresnian cognac?
For heaven's sakes, Chekhov, don't interrupt a man on the verge of toasting the best ship in the fleet with the finest cognac on this side of the galaxy.
My apologies.
I don't know if we could have gotten through that door. Those double
Questions
doors?
Later, then. The toast. Here's to the starship Enterprise.
Alert? What are you doing to the Enterprise? You're a bad man after all.
A conspiracy, if you ask me, Captain.
Let me pull this up on screen.
That's not good.
They've destroyed my camera. Well, let's see how they deal with our other security systems.
That didn't work either.
Captain Kirk, wherever he goes, trouble seems to be waiting. The chief engineer was looking forward to an idyllic day, sipping cognac and looking at old machinery.
Alas, was not meant to be.
Chekhov is determined to find out who would harm such a fine gentleman with ties to the old country, then enjoy the rest of his shore leave. Ignoring the slight ozone odor, the curator looks peacefully asleep.
Oh, from the blast that got him?
Look around, gentlemen. Let's see if we can find something to solve this little mystery.
I do not know what we should do next, Captain. Maybe I can wring some information out of that security panel.
Perhaps.
This is not quite the shore leave I expected, Captain.
By now, you should expect it.
An old suit of armor, but with a strong framework added inside to avoid any accidents. It's holding a large metal lance in its right gauntlet.
Cool.
An old suit.
Let us don the armor.
We learned as children playing chess, it's never a good idea to randomly move your knight about.
I wanted to put it on.
An enormous bottle of cognac. The plaque below reads, "This Jeroboam of Kazakhstanian cognac is from the first blending and 40-year aging on Nova Atar." This glass birdhouse is the nesting place of a Brecknerian swallow. A small, tantalizing goblet of cognac, waiting for the warm touch of Mr. Scott's hand to gently release its vapors. A small conference table and chairs. The curator's office is an interesting mix of the old and new. The curator's desk, neat, organized.
Oh, that's a laptop or something.
A monitoring and control station for museum security. This is the screen where the curator monitors the rest of the museum. A solid-looking door with no handles.
I don't understand what you want me to do, Captain. Why, certainly, Captain.
On second thought, Scotty, you better leave that alone.
Captain, I don't see how a pigeon is going to help us.
Is that what that is, a pigeon?
I don't understand what you want me to do, Captain.
Check this out.
Captain, they've got a wee button under here to let the curator open the door without getting up.
So that's how we open the door.
This is a very expensive silver tray.
Now it's our silver tray. Well, we don't even have a... That's right, we weren't allowed to bring any electronic devices. So we don't have a... You know... tricorder or anything.
A standard silver serving tray.
I feel rather bad about this, Captain.
I do too, Scotty, but it's always surprising what you need in an emergency.
This is not really nice of us. We took it, and we wouldn't let Scotty take it.
A rather large bottle of Kazakhstanian cognac.
There's something disturbing about a bird in a cage. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Pressing the button. Won't the bad guys get in now? Okay, good to know though.
Don't we have more important things to do than bird watching, Captain? This is a bit beyond me, Captain.
We got something else there underneath.
I wonder what this is for.
I wonder what the hell it is. A letter?
The note on the paper reads, Bresnia, VVSOP 2123.
Hmm.
The curator's office.
Captain, I don't know what we could possibly use these for.
Let's check out the monitoring center, what have you.
Simple trap, simple to disarm. Whoever did this must have figured the curator would not be expecting it.
Yeah, they figured right. Now what are you gonna do? Arm the trap again?
I wonder if we can get any other information out of the security system.
That's what I'm trying to do. I guess we need to use Scotty to do that. Just wonder if Chekhov would say anything. Well, he's gonna go over and give it a try, I guess.
I've gone over the system, Captain, and it's a mess. All the security modules are cut off from each other. When the curator touched the panel, it set off triggers all over the museum. Somebody had a lot of access to things.
And we don't know who they are, what they want, or how long we have to stop them.
Hmm. What if I tried Scotty?
Captain, I found the floor plans for that room in here. The room used to house a small aquarium. Whoever's in there probably slid the phasers up a drain under an access panel. That's why the security system did not take notice.
At least it's too small for them to crawl out.
Aye, but it's close to a main drain, which is big enough. With the phasers they've got, I'd say they could tunnel out in about 2 hours.
Won't the Enterprise detect the phaser fire?
Not with that force field sitting above the museum.
And we can't shut that off since the security system modules aren't on speaking terms.
Aye, Captain. They've thought of everything.
We'll see, Mr. Scott.
Hmm. Interesting. Well, I guess we're gonna leave the room. We'll see if Chekhov will do it or if he'll just say something. Okay. I don't suppose any of this stuff here is worth looking at.
The curator's office isn't. The curator's. The curator.
And what things do we have again? Okay. Let us save.
Save new game. Replace delete preview. Replace preview.
Captain, what will we do when we get to the other room and the door closes?
Well, can we wake this guy up?
You get no response.
We don't have a med kit or anything.
I wish Bones were here. He's out, but I can't tell you how bad it is.
Maybe a wee bit of cognac would help him out.
Do you really think that's wise, Mr. Scott?
Kinda like the hair of the dog, Captain.
Then wouldn't we want to zap him again?
Why don't we let Dr. McCoy handle this later?
I want to try giving him the cognac. And why would we not want to zap him later?
He's unconscious, Captain.
Thanks, Mr. Chekhov. I was just thinking how useless it would have been for Dr. McCoy to have come with us.
Alright, let's try the cognac then.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Drink.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Oh, sheesh.
I don't understand what you want me to do, Captain.
Drink it! We can't leave the room? What if I put the platter here to stop it from...
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Captain, what will we do when we get to the other room and the door closes?
Okay, what if it's just him?
This is a bit beyond me, Captain.
Alright, so we can't leave the room.
This is a bit beyond me, Captain.
What are we doing with it?
The large lance shows somewhere.
Oh, we can take the lance. Cool.
A rather worn lance.
I wanted to do this.
Save new game. Cancel. Delete. Replace. Pre.
And then... kill.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
I'm already kind of stuck. We can't leave the room? We gotta stop the door from closing.
The curator's desk. Neat. Organized.
I'm thinking we put something in the way of the door.
Maybe it would help to go look in the other rooms, Captain.
Oh, I'd love to, but we can't leave, apparently.
This is not quite the shore leave I expected, Captain.
Look around, gentlemen. Let's see if we can find something to solve this little mystery.
Captain, what will we do?
Then the door will close. That's all, Chekhov. We'll be on the other side of it.
Captain, what will we do?
Brother. What's this? Is there anything here? I need the eyes. The eyes.
A small conference table and chairs.
Can I get anything else? Can I get a chair?
No effect. No effect. No effect. No effect. No effect.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
What if I...
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
The button is there, right? Yeah. What if we splatter cognac on it and short out the...
No, I don't think that's necessary.
I want to open it again. Stop your crap, Kirk. Alright, splatter stuff.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
Short out equipment.
No, I don't think that's necessary.
What do we do with stuff?
No, I don't think that's necessary. I wonder if we can get any other information out of this. No, I don't think that's necessary.
There's not a whole lot of
Mr.
stuff.
Mr. Chekhov, see if you can wedge that knot under the door.
Yes,
exactly. I knew we were going to wedge something. Why'd it close now?
There, that should hold the door open.
Indeed, saving over.
Save new game. Replace pre-
Let's exit the room.